Give me three.
Hey, Bob. Give me that beer. Come on. You see that guy? Was it you, boy?
It's the fella you called me down here to talk deals with.
Go get him.
Get him? Are you...
Hey, boy.
Holly, come on, sweetheart.
Beat it.
Holly.
Beat it. Hey, boy.
Does it? I'll see you later, Travis.
Owen, wait a minute. Now, he ain't gonna like it. He told me the man gives him a bigger cut. But he's gonna cause all kind of bad trouble. All kind.
Well, then maybe he should be dealt with on his own level. Adios.
I'm sorry. Are you all right?
Anita, no frijoles, huh?
Qué bueno, hombre. Qué bueno, eh? Hola!
Holy! Holy! Stop it!
Bastante, eh? Finito!
Olé.
Anita, eh? Macho, macho.
¿Qué pasó? Allí. Perdón, señores.
Y señoras, cuando yo soy un...
Thank you.
Cade wants to see me?
Yes, sir, he does. He's in the back hall. We'll go straight on through.
Well, the ME says it cut the aorta. Probably dropped him like a pole steer. I guess that's why nobody heard him yell.
Sam, how do you always manage to find me when I poured myself a cold drink?
Second sight, hombre.
Oh. Holy bacon, huh?
Yeah.
Any thoughts?
We have a name. Esteban Sanchez. It could be in your department. They're having a fight in the bar and a couple of witnesses found him standing over the body.
Sanchez?
Yeah.
Bartender thought he might be an illegal. Works up there at Taylor Hargett's ranch.
No, no. Sanchez got his resident visa last year. I know him and his wife. Baby on the way.
He's never given us any trouble.
Sanchez carry a knife?
I don't think so, Sam.
Why, what are you getting at, Sheriff?
Well, if Coley Baker here was expecting more trouble from Sanchez, why didn't he use this?
Did any of the witnesses give the Sands Motel as an address?
No, sir, they didn't.
All right, ask the bartender to give you a rundown on everybody who has been in here today. All right? Sinatra, I'm going to need a border check.
Okay, Sam, but I'm telling you, I know Sanchez and his wife. He'll be back on his own.
Sheriff,
report from Unit 4. They're out at the Hargett Ranch now. Is Sanchez's bungalow? It's empty.
Empty?
Yes, sir. Sanchez's clothes are gone, and...
Well, what about his wife?
She's gone, too.
Mr. Jackson, come in here right away, please.
Yeah, Sheriff.
What kept you?
Oh, I wanted to finish a historical novel out about halfway through. Mm. What's eating you, son?
A fugitive named Sanchez. This is his description. Yeah, put out an APB, will you?
He's facing a murder?
Yeah, his wife is probably with him. I don't know her given name.
It's Felice.
What?
Felice.
Oh. Well, in that case, you'd better get over to the Hargett Ranch and get a description of her, because that's where she worked.
I see. 5'3½", 110 pounds, black eyes, black hair. Got a moon-shaped scar on her right forearm. She's 8 months pregnant.
Are you kidding? What are you talking about? How'd you know this?
She's in my office now. She's been waiting to see you for the last 20 minutes.
For Pete's sake, J.J. Honesty. Mrs. Sanchez? I'm Sheriff Cade.
I just came to tell you, Mr. Cade, that my husband could no more kill another man than he could grow another head.
Well, where is he?
I don't know. I haven't seen him since breakfast.
Your husband came home after the murder. His clothes are all gone.
You didn't know that, Miss Sanchez?
No. I started for town as soon as I heard the police were after him.
How'd you get here?
I walked. Somebody told me you were a pretty good man, Mr. Cade, for an Anglo. I wanted to tell you how my husband really is, not how he looks, how he is.
All right, suppose you tell me.
He never lies. He loves this country. He went to school every night for 4 years to get a high school diploma. Now, he's studying the law. He never thinks things are so bad they can't change. He wants a daughter. He says we'll name her Georgia Washington Sanchez. And maybe she'll be the first Chicana president.
Does your husband own a knife?
No. Why?
The man that was killed was stabbed.
Stabbed? Well, then that's it. Esteban couldn't have done it. done it.
Why not, ma'am?
He's scared to death of knives. He almost cut off his hand when he was a little boy. They had to change his job at the ranch. Mr. Hargett put him on the oil rig.
Well, it would seem that I should have a talk with Taylor Hargett.
Yeah, just about time.
Hi, Sam.
How are you, Taylor?
Afternoon, sir.
Hi, Counselor.
You know it's been a bad day for me. Huh? We got clobbered on the stock market yesterday. The state, they're going to build a new dam on my spread to cancel that. And now I got 500 feet of pipe stuck up there in that dry well. So if you got any news for me, Sam, I hope it's good news.
Well, no, I haven't. I'm looking for an oil rigger who works for you called Sanchez.
Oh, yeah, so I heard. I haven't seen him, Sam. All right, boys, come on. What are you afraid of? Push it.
Coley Baker worked around here, didn't he?
Off and on, yes. Why?
I thought you might be acquainted with some of his friends.
Or enemies.
Come on, Samuel. What's this pitch? You know who did the killing.
Did he have a girlfriend?
Sure, he had a girl.
What was her name?
Anita Drew.
Anita?
Hey, sir. Are you still here? What do you want, an affidavit from me or something, huh? Listen, if I see Sanchez, I'll call you.
All right, suppose you do that. Huh?
Sure.
Say, what does Sanchez do before you put him on the rigs?
Oh, well, there's a wrangler, mended fence, one thing and another like
you know,
that.
You know, I heard something. I don't know how true it is, but somebody told me he was scared of knives.
Knives?
Yeah, did you ever hear that?
No. Oh, where'd you hear?
It doesn't matter. Oh, by the way, do you own any property in town?
Yes, you do.
Huh?
Well, don't tell me you've forgotten. There's a motel, the same.
Oh, that.
Oh, thanks. I'll see you around.
All right, sir.
Bye, Dad.
I'm looking for Esteban Sanchez. Any of you guys seen him?
That was a pointless lie, Taylor. All he has to do is look it up in the court records.
Coley and Claire?
Yeah.
Travis?
Sure.
Yourself?
Yeah.
Speaking of records, the motel.
No, the manager doesn't know that much. But I will have him clean out that room we used.
You got a... and a girl, huh? You better get her out of town before Cade finds out what her name is.
He's already got it.
What?
I gave it to him.
You what?
Taylor, how long do you think it would take him to get it on his own?
It's one thing after another. Never ends. Just never ends.
It'll end if I can find Sanchez. Been thinking about a bullet in the head and a suicide note.
Not sure I had that much time. He's getting too close.
Cade? I think I can buy you the time, Taylor.
How?
Kill him.
TV Land. Watch it all.
No, I wouldn't call him a boyfriend. He was an acquaintance.
Were you with Coley at the Lobo Inn today?
For a while.
You left before the fight started?
I left because of the fight. He's always pulling some dumb trick like that.
Like what exactly?
Like showing up someplace for something important, and then getting in a fight before...
Before what?
We could have any fun.
Do you know Travis Spencer?
No, I don't think so.
Well, that's very strange. The bartender said he saw you and Travis and Coley sitting at a table about noon.
He's wrong. We were sitting alone.
Yes, but he also said something else. He said that there was maybe a third man there, but he didn't recognize
We were sitting alone.
What are you afraid of, Miss Drew?
I am not afraid. I'm mad, that's what I am. A man was killed today, and everybody but the law seems to know who did it. Now, if you get off the dime, Mr. Sheriff, and go looking for this... Hello? Oh... Yeah, just a second. Are you through?
Yeah, almost. Oh, except there's one thing, though. How did you meet Coley?
Through my work.
Through your work? Well, what is your work?
Scales operator, state truck inspection.
Well, he was driving a truck, huh?
Yes, he was driving a truck and he was overweight, and I asked him to come around again.
You know what he hauled?
Nothing important. I don't know. Farm machinery.
Well, do you know who he worked for?
I can't remember.
That's all right. We can look it up. Even a big help. Thanks.
Travis? I'm sorry, it was some salesman. Police? Are you kidding? I wouldn't talk to the police. You mean now? Well, I'm not dressed or anything, and I... Okay, yeah. I'll meet you. Yeah, I'll be there.
All right, charge him with burning trash in the city limits, find him and let him go. Say, you asked for someone to take a look at the Sands Motel when you called in, so I sent Rudy over. Manager's name's Grissom. Fat, little nervous kind of a fella. When Rudy asked him if he could take a look around, he said, no, sir, not over my dead body. He got kind of feisty, and Rudy thought he ought to bring him in.
Friend of Coley Baker's?
Claimed he'd never heard of him.
Yeah.
Rudy checked with a couple of the neighbors. They identified Baker's picture, said they'd seen him around there a half a dozen times. Him and some white-haired, distinguished-looking fella.
What was that you were saying about trash out there?
Oh, he had a fire going on an old empty oil barrel when Rudy got there.
Rudy couldn't see what they were burning?
No, it's paper and junk. We told him what the neighbor said and asked him again about Baker. We couldn't shake him.
Sheriff?
Yeah.
Here's the rest of that breakdown you wanted. Everybody's at the Lobo Inn this morning, including the name the bartender was a little vague on. Fourth member of Coley Baker's party.
Coley Baker, Anita Drew, Travis Spencer, Owen Routh.
Speaking of white-haired, distinguished-looking fellows.
JJ, get out a search warrant. Send a fingerprint man over to the Sands Motel. See what they can pick up in the office. Oh, and sift that oil can. See if we can find any readable ashes.
Check.
Sam, what's Routh got to do with all this?
I don't know. It's taking on quite a size, Arlo. Because if Routh's mixed up in it, Taylor is too. I tell you what, get a hold of Routh, will you? Tell him I want to have a little talk with him.
Right. Sam.
Yeah?
Before you look for any more trails, take a ride out with me to Hargett's.
I have some very bad news. Felisa Sanchez is an illegal.
You sure?
Positive. And Hargett has at least seven other illegals working for him, including Sanchez's brother, Carlos.
Mrs. Sanchez, something's come up. We haven't been able to put it together because I haven't been able to find all the pieces. But if your husband is innocent, it isn't the police he has to fear.
Melissa!
Crazy. He's different.
None of them is different.
What do you think you're doing, Cade?
You don't have to be told the immigration laws, Hargett.
You don't mean persecution laws, do you? Huh? What the hell is the idea? You come barging in here, shoving these good people around like they're a bunch of cattle? Look, they got homes on this ranch. They can live here. They got families. Who gave you the right to tear up their lives?
The laws were made to protect the illegals, too, Mr. Hargett.
Protect them from what?
From ranchers who take advantage of them, who exploit them, make paying them much less than they are worth because they know they are illegal and can't complain. That's why.
Yeah? I see.
Mrs. Sanchez!
Esteban, listen. I'm so worried. Why don't you go see Mr. Cade?
Oh, wrong again. Just crazier.
Felicity, you go on to Nogales. I will see you there. Now go on.
How will you get across the border?
El Señor Hargett will help me.
Sure. He's outside right now. All you have to do is walk over and ask him. Go ahead.
I heard him say he'd be at his cabin tomorrow night. I will see him then.
But Mr. Cade said that...
Mr. Cade is a policeman, Felicia. He does not care about us. Felicia, I will see El Señor Hargett. Now go on.
Mrs. Sanchez! Mrs. Sanchez!
Hey, stop it! Stop him!
Natural Trip is a proud sponsor of TV Land.
Palmolive Lemon Antibacterial. Ta-da!
Oh, he's the handsomest boy I've ever seen. Listen, I don't want to tire you, Mrs. Sanchez, but I do have one question I must ask you. Do you mind?
No.
Yesterday, you said that Hargett changed your husband's job because he wouldn't or he couldn't handle knives. Is that correct?
That's right.
Well, what was his job?
Making wooden pack frames. Carving, you know.
Did Hargett tell your husband what they were for? I mean, those pack frames, what did he use them for?
To go camping. There was some secret about it. He wouldn't let Esteban work on them at the ranch house.
Well, where did he work?
There was a shack. Right on the border, far southeastern end of the property.
I see. You get some rest now. You take care.
Oh, thank you for the flowers, Sheriff. And thank you for delivering my son.
Now, he's an American citizen, you know, born in this country. How about that, huh?
How about that?
Oh, she's fine. She's just fine.
Did she like my flowers?
Sure, she sure did.
Well, there's two things. We struck out in readable print at the motel, but the lab said that some of them ashes has been heroin packets. And the second thing is, Arlo can't find Owen Routh.
Nacho, what do pack frames suggest to you?
Well, Sam, I have a suspicious mind.
Yeah.
Especially when someone mentions heroin. Smuggling, of course.
Want to take a trip? Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
Sheriff. What you looking for? Help yourself. Is something wrong, Sheriff?
Using these lately?
Cranes haven't been used in quite a spell.
Why, they're damp. Looks like they've been in the river.
Sam! Hold it!
Don't move.
Sorry, Sam. There's no way I could have waved it.
Stand up.
Name's Travis Spencer.
And you?
Peter Canal. Put your hands up.
These things are 18 pounders. What are they hauling them?
You fill those with 18 pounds of heroin, you could buy half of the state. They're worth up in the millions.
You think a bunch of pack rams would make a man like Travis so nervous, huh? It just doesn't make sense. Fear than I thought.
Well? Sam, I don't... I got 400 or 500 people up there on the payroll working for me. I can't remember everybody's name or face.
Oh, come on. Travis Spencer isn't the kind of an employee that you'd be likely to forget.
You're snapping at my heels, son.
I'm looking for reasons. I already got 2 of your employees dead on my hands.
I'm not running a nursery school up there, Sam. Some of the guys work for me. They play pretty rough. Figures at times. They got fights, a man gets hurt, some man got killed. But that goes with the territory.
Anita Drew go with the territory?
Anita Drew?
Yeah.
Never heard of her.
Owen Routh has.
Owen Routh has a lot of girls, eh?
Yeah. Where is he?
Who knows? I'm not his keeper. Yeah.
Where was he yesterday? And what was your motel manager burning when my deputies arrived?
Now look, Sam, I don't need to... Sheriff. I know you got a lot of problems. I want to get to the bottom of this as bad as you do. Believe me, I do. But right now, it just doesn't make any sense to me. None of it. Hey, Sam. Look, I got to go up to my cabin for a couple of days. There's a mountain cat up there that's been cutting down some of my sheep, you know. Why don't you come along, huh? Relax. Unwind a little. We'll drink some good whiskey, a few laughs, tell a few lies. What do you say?
Another time, Taylor. All right?
Sure, sir. Another time.
Ah, Sam.
I just talked to the Mexican police. They told me they think there's an international ring from the Middle East running heroin through Mexico into the States. They're going to give us all the cooperation they can.
Thanks, Nacho.
How about Harga? Have you got any place for him?
Not an inch.
Oh, Sheriff?
Yeah, that's fine.
Unit 3 to Madrid Central.
Madrid Central? Go ahead.
JJ's still hammering away at that drover you brought in, that Pekin Ab. Says he'd like to see you whenever you get a minute.
All right. Take care of this, will you?
Okay.
Well, it's your neck, son. If I was in your boots, you got some kind of an idea if he keeps his mouth shut, he's safe.
How old are you? Oh, come on, that's not self-incrimination. How old are you?
I'm 18.
18. Have you been informed of your rights?
Yeah, I guess so.
What do you mean, you guess so? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Who's your lawyer?
He wants Owen Routh. We still can't find him.
All right. I'm gonna lay it on the line for you. That girl tried to fight for her life, but she ended up with a bullet in the back of her head. We're going to ask for a murder one indictment.
No, sir, that girl was dead before I got there.
Oh, yes, of course she was dead. And you know something? You know what we found in her fist?
No, sir, what did you find in her fist?
A button. This button.
Mr. Cade?
You know something? You know, I can't figure it out. You don't have any police record. I mean, you don't even have a traffic citation. All right? Was this the first time you've been in trouble?
Yes, sir.
Well, how'd that happen?
Well, Mr. Cade, I didn't know he was going to kill her. I mean, I wouldn't so much as whoop a dog, much less... Well, you were right about her fighting. I mean, he told me to grab her, and I didn't, and he shot her.
All right, okay. Take it easy now. What did Travis do with those pack frames?
Oh, well, you were right on.
Right on.
Yes, sir.
Heroin?
Yes, sir. He hauled heroin.
I thought so.
Come out of Mexico?
Yes, sir. Right across from the shack. That's why we were down there.
Well, who else is in on it?
Travis. Well, his truck driver named... Coley.
Coley Baker?
Yes, sir. Coley Baker.
And the girl?
Yes, sir. The girl was in it, too. I mean, Travis just figured she knew too much.
When's the next shipment going through?
Well, that's today. Or later today.
Same place at the shack?
Yes, sir. That's the only place they can do it. Only place they figure the Border Patrol won't be. Send for one other place, way west of there.
How far west?
About 40 miles below Congress.
All right, that'll be all. Thank you, Pete. Get a statement from him, J.J. Oh, and get a hold of Nacho. Tell him he's invited to a surprise party. 40 miles below Congress.
This portion of TV Land is brought to you by...
I'm going to Harker's cabin. Nacho. Sit.
All right, take them in.
I figured somebody broke. What are you doing? Where'd you come from?
Mr. Hargood, I'm sorry. But I was hungry, so I thought you wouldn't mind. So I...
Oh, you broke in, huh?
I'll pay for the lock.
Oh, forget the lock. It's all right. Don't worry about the lock. All alone?
Yes, sir. Senor Hargood, I need help.
Well, you came to the right place, son.
I didn't kill Collie Baker.
I know that, Sanchez. I know that.
Can you get me into Mexico?
Sure. Nothing would be easier.
I don't know what to say. I just...
Just don't say anything, son.
Mr. Hart, please.
Down, Taylor.
There he is. There's your murder suspect.
Forget it.
No. You don't understand. He busted into my cabin, tried to kill me. I got a shot at him. He broke through the doors. I chased him here.
Don't do it.
You take these people into your... You treat them like your own family. Your own kids, you know? You see what happens?
I said to drop that gun.
You wouldn't shoot me, Sam.
Sanchez! Come on up.
We got on Roth with all your heroin. All right, who killed Coley Baker?
Travis. Called he wanted a bigger cut.
Why, Taylor? Why?
Sam, don't you see these people of mine? They think I'm the greatest, the richest guy in the territory. When the bankers back east, they hung me out on a line. I was going to take everything. I had to do something. I couldn't let them take all I worked. $3 million would have bailed me out. Besides, I didn't want it just for myself. I wanted to be able to take care of my people.
I saw.
Huh?
I saw how you took care of them. Did he wing you?
It's nothing.
Well, I got news for you.
Yes, sir.
It's a boy.
I didn't know about that.
Now, he may be the first Chicano prisoner. Why don't you name him George? How about that, huh?
George. That's a nice name for a president. But I kind of like Sam. Thank you very much, Mr. Cade.
Let's go.
This is TV Land.